My name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda with AV Ultra, and welcome back to our Premiere Pro introductory lessons. This is a set of 10 lessons to get you up and running with Premiere Pro, and this is lesson 4, all about importing media into Premiere Pro. Again, I am using Premiere Pro 2015.4 in the year 2016, so they've got a great naming convention thing going on. Let's go ahead and get started. In the last lesson, we took a look at sequences and setting up sequences. So I have a 1080p sequence here started. You'll notice though that I don't have any media in here. So how can I bring media into Premiere Pro? Well, we have a couple of different ways. We can go to File, Import, and we also have a shortcut key of Command I, or I believe that is Control I on Windows machines. Otherwise, I can come down here into my project window and I can right click and go to Import, or I can just double click anywhere in this empty space. So if I double click in this empty space, if I right click and hit Import, or if I go to File, Import, or hit Command, Control, I, the same thing happens. It opens up a dialog box of what exactly you want to import. Now, I have a series of different things here that I want to import, and we're going to take a look at them. I have just a couple pictures here. So this was in a trip to Vegas of last year where I did some training for MGM Grand International Resorts. Lovely people, great time there. And I just want to bring in a couple of these images. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the picture I want to bring in, and I'm going to go ahead and hit Import. And what that's done is that has now brought it into my project panel. If I double click this, there's my image. And I want to go ahead and bring a couple more things in. So normally, I'm going to want to bring in video, so I have a couple different videos in here. This video was shot actually last year in 2015. I was testing out an Atomos Assassin, and this is a 4K piece of video that I'm going to bring in. And so I'm going to go ahead and import that, and I'm going to import a few other things. So I have a couple other videos here. These are at 1280 by 720. If I want to import more than one item, well, I can just highlight a couple different items here, and I'm going to click Import. And let's bring in just a couple more. So I have a piece of paper. I have this other picture I want to bring in. I've got some music MP3s I want to bring in, and a couple more pieces of footage here. So here I have just some audio, and that's what that looks like. If I double click this, I can play this back and hear some audio. I can double click my images or my video files. And I can clearly see my different items. If I'm shooting a series of images, mostly with like a DSLR camera or really any camera that names them in order of the photos that were shot, one thing to be aware of is that we can actually bring things in as an image sequence. So in here, I've got a series of GoPro images that was a time lapse of the sunset over by Lake Mead. And so I have a bunch of different pictures here. It looks like at least 100 and some pictures. And if I click on the first one here and click on this button, Image Sequence, what this is going to do is instead of bringing in every single file one at a time, it's going to import them all at once. And so this actually created a movie file out of all those different images. And I can play that back and see my time lapse. There's not a whole lot going on here because there was no clouds there, but you can see them moving just off into the distance. As we took a look at before, if I come over here to look at my resolution, because this was taken in the photo settings of my GoPro, this is much larger than, say, a 1920 by 1080. So I actually have 3000 by 2250 that I can bring into my timeline, which means I can kind of zoom in and crop without losing any resolution. I have a couple different things in here that I've imported. There's one or two more things I want to talk about importing into Premiere Pro, and that's namely Photoshop files and Illustrator documents. If I bring in an Illustrator document, so I'm just going to look for one. Let's see what pops up. This should be good. Oh, this is the No One Leaves the Circus, part of a project I was in. And I can hit Import, And notice it brings it in as an Illustrator file, but still honors everything. What's great about this is I can actually right-click this and say Edit Original down here. And this will actually open up Illustrator. And any changes I make to the Illustrator document and hit Save will update here. That's really useful. Here's another project I was working on. And this is the dialogue I get when I bring in a Photoshop document. I can actually merge all the layers together that will give me one flattened JPEG looking image here, or I can merge individual layers or bring it all in as a sequence. If I bring this in as its own sequence, I'll get a new folder, and in that folder, I'll have all the different layers that were in there and a sequence that has the original setup of all the different slides in here, all the different layers. So I can actually turn some of these on or off. And so you can see how that's updating and changing my different images. So this is great if I have something pre-mocked up in Photoshop, and then I can selectively work with each one of these layers to animate them in Premiere Pro. When we are importing items into Premiere Pro, we are referencing different files. What that means is Premiere Pro doesn't actually bring anything into the program. It is merely looking at my computer and saying, hey, this file isn't stored within Premiere Pro, it is only referenced. Meaning that if I hit Reveal in Finder, this is that particular clip right here. And if this drive is removed, it is no longer accessible. As an example, I have this whole lesson 3 here. I'm just gonna toss this out really quick. So let's pretend this was on a card that you had connected to Premiere Pro, you imported a bunch of stuff, and then you ejected the card because you wanna keep working on it. Well, that doesn't necessarily work because as soon as I come back to Premiere Pro, it says, hey, you're missing all this footage that I last saw. Here's where it was last seen. Here's the name of the clip, the file name, and all the information about it. And I can either look for it or you can hit cancel right now. And if I have cancel, you'll notice what happens to all my clips. They are no longer connected. In fact, the only one that is connected is this No One Leaves the Circus because that's on a separate drive. So how can I get that back? If I click on any one of these items, it's going to say, hey, this is actually missing. This is an offline file and I can't do anything with it. If I drag this into my timeline to try and work with it, it's not going to show up. You can see that there, it just says media offline. This is something that I see very, very common, and you need to be aware wherever you put your media, it needs to live there. You can't be ejecting it or getting rid of it because then it will no longer be accessible to Premiere Pro. So this is another reason why typically when we as video editors have separate drives that we just keep our media onto. One thing that I do is I'll take my footage and I'll bring it into my computer and make a folder for it. And so you can see here, I have several different folders. There's my Assassin in Phangnam Bay, in Phuket, in the Khao Suk Jungle, and in Shanghai. And I have all my media here. And this is where it ends up just living. And I don't ever remove this from my computer until I'm 100% done with it. Now I'm just gonna go back into my trash and undo that lesson 3 so it's still accessible again. This is why it's important to be aware of your project settings and where you're storing your items. Now, it still can't find those last clips. What I can do is come up to File, Link Media. And when I go to Link Media, it's gonna say, hey, where was this last image found? Notice I'm just searching for this one right now, and that's okay. I can just say, hey, search in that last place that I saw it, and it's gonna look through the whole computer where it was last seen, and it says, hey, I think this is the image right here. And I can say, yeah, you know what, that is that same image, and I'll hit okay. And what that will do is link up that one piece of media. If I have nothing selected here, notice I can't link my media. What I can do is select everything, right click, and link media, and now it's gonna show me everything at once. And I can say, make sure everything is exactly where it is, where it was, and locate that. Now, if you've moved this from one drive to another, you can still locate it by file name and type, and just point to the new path, and it'll actually link that up. Now this went ahead and picked it all out, so I'm just gonna hit OK. And now there is all my media all linked up again. So now I can still access everything and place it into my timeline. If you're using the brand new version of Premiere Pro as of 2016, we have an option to actually copy all our media into the project. That's called our ingest and proxy settings. That is a little bit more advanced. However, that does take care of this problem, but adds quite a lot more media to your drives. If that's something that you're interested in, be sure to look up proxy media in Adobe Premiere Pro. So that's how we import different media into Premiere Pro. Again, be very careful about where exactly you're storing your media, as it needs to continually be accessible by Premiere Pro. So you want to keep it on a specific drive. I'd recommend naming it in specific folders and leaving it there until you are ready to completely trash the project. In the next lesson, what we're going to do is we're going to start looking at how to cut up our footage and bring it into the timeline. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Luberda, and this is the Introduction to Premiere Pro training course provided free by AV Ultra. Thanks a lot, and hopefully you found this useful.